baby in the family. Happy, happy home. Happy, happy home. Happy, happy home. And baby in the family. Happy, happy home. Happy, happy home. With mommy in the family. Happy, happy home. Happy, happy home. Happy, happy home. And baby in the family. Happy, happy home. Happy, happy home. With daddy in the family. Happy, happy home. Happy, happy home. Happy, happy home. When daddy in the family. Happy, happy home. Happy, happy home. When Jesus in the family. Happy, happy home. Happy, happy home. Happy, happy home. When Jesus in the family. Happy, happy home. Happy, happy home.
Today we're reading a very cute story about two unlikely, not people, but animals that find each other. But they do have a very interesting line in the end that they want to share with you. And sometimes it might be hard to feel like you want to be yourself, but it's always probably the best thing to do. So let's read about the Lamaroo today and see what they have to share with us. The Lamaroo by Diana Kempton and Rosalind Bearshaw. She popped him in her pouch and hopped back to show everyone her wonderful new baby. The lamb felt safe in her pouch. He wasn't alone anymore, and he was happy. He loved his new ma and all his new friends and relatives. Only one thing worried him. He was different from everyone else. Everyone else in the family had smooth brown fur, but he was covered with thick white wool. Everyone else in the family could do huge jumps, but he could only do little ones. "Look at me, look at me," he shouted. "I can jump just like you." His ma hopped out of the house wearing an old blanket. "Look at me, look at me," she shouted. "I'm covered in wool just like you." The lamb stopped jumping. He looked at his ma and felt very sad. He couldn't see her arms. He couldn't see her brown fur. And worst of all, he couldn't see her safe, warm pouch. "You don't look like my ma anymore," he cried. "And you don't look like my lamb," cried his ma. The lamb looked down and saw that she was right. The springs were big and twisty. They had sharp, pointy ends. There was no way he could fit in his ma's pouch with them on his feet. The lamb pulled off his springs as quickly as he could. Then his ma threw away her blanket so they both looked like themselves again. The lamb jumped happily back into his ma's pouch, and for the very first time, he didn't mind being different. He didn't mind having a thick woolly coat, and he didn't mind not being able to do huge jumps. He was perfectly happy to be the only Lamaroo in the world.
All families are different. Some families are small, some families are big. You can have your family by birth or adoption. That's all for now, bye.